Hi there, folks. Do you know what time it is? It's time for Pokemon. I always love some sweet, pure, good old-fashioned, wholesome animal violence. Give me the classic story of a god that's controlled by a prepubescent child. Let me live the dream of beating up everyone in the world breaking a sweat. You know, you gotta catch them all. Okay, so I got Pokemon Scarlet the day it came out. My girly girl decided to send me money. Gotta love having a sugar mama. Not really. She just likes spoiling me. I was gonna get it eventually, but didn't have the money right then, so I was gonna wait till around Christmas when I got my bonus from work. She was not willing to wait that long for version exclusives. I honestly have really enjoyed the game. The first Pokemon game I played was Sword and Shield, so I was so hyped for Scarlet and Violet. I've been a Pokemon fan since I was, like, 8. But my family couldn't afford to get me a DS and related games. I had too many siblings, gotta love that. I have to say, Scarlet and Violet, good. The open world feel is very nice, and the Pokemon spawning in the overworld is just kind of like, wow, that feels right. They did not hesitate to make the small mons small and the big mons big. Seeing the size comparison to the player versus all of the Pokemon is really cool. And it was cool to spot something moving in the grass and just be like, ooh, what's that? It really felt very immersive. God, and the first wild battle I got into shook me to my core. I could not believe it took place in the overworld. I was just sitting there like, oh? That doesn't mean the game has no problems, because let's be honest, there's quite a few things in it that are a bit messy, and it's kinda glitchy. The Tara Raid battles feel bad. The timer on them is just awful, and the fighting itself is not fun. Pokemon is a turn-based game, and the Tara Raids don't feel turn-based. They feel like that semi-turn-based style that FNAF World had, and I don't like it. It's really frustrating when you are about to click the button to attack, and the Terramon is just like, nope, and does something that requires an animation that takes over the entire screen. Not to mention that move animations take too long. It's so frustrating to have to watch the full animation to terrestrialize your Pokemon when the timer is just ticking down. It's just frustrating, it's nail-biting in the worst kind of way. So, I've been mostly avoiding the Tara Raids, especially the 5-star Tara Raids, though the XP candy is very nice. But that's late game, so let's shift back to the beginning, to the starters. So, like many, I had already seen the first stage of the starters, and instantly, I fell in love with Fukoko. He's just a little pepper, and his teeth. That man could commit war crimes, and I'd still love him. Yeah, I melted when I saw him. Like a block of butter that was chucked into the fire pit. So, I chose him as my starter, and I named mine Hot Pocket. Let me tell you, it was the right choice. Fukoko's final evolution, and the little bird on its head, brilliant. Not to mention that it's brilliant how the little flame on Fukoko's head looks like dried grass, the kind a bird would build a nest out of. And then, boom, stage two, it has a bird's nest on its head with an egg in it. Then, the final has a little firebird. Yep, I love it. Give me more. Not to mention, Skeledirge is a quadruped. He is the chosen one, the one we all wanted and prayed for. Not to mention that the name Skeledirge is such a clever name for a ghost-type Pokemon that is a singer. It's a combo of the words skeleton and dirge. Do you know what a dirge is? If you don't, a dirge is a funeral song. So Skeledirge is a singer that's a skeleton that sings at funerals. Ah, it scratches all of the right itches in my brain. Please forgive me for this, but I also want to talk about how cool I think Skeledirge's design is. Just at a glance, you don't see how much music-related stuff was shoved into this thing. He's designed after a jazz club singer from like the 1930s. He has a black rim around his head that resembles a fedora, and his markings look like a suit. His suit looks more like a composer's suit than a jazz singer, but it feels right. My man is dripping with snazz, and that's not even talking about the fact that its skull markings on its face both resemble a sugar skull and a guitar or like a banjo. How did they manage to shove all of this into one mon and not have it feel like it was overdesigned or cluttered? It's pretty clear I'm a Skeledirge fangirl. I'm not sorry about it whatsoever. Nintendo did good with this one. So, the drawing on screen was because I thought it would be funny to redesign my skeleton boy as if he was designed to represent dancing instead of Quackuval. It tickles me pink to see an alligator be the dance theme starter. Imagining an alligator standing up and trying to dance when its body is so clearly not made for dancing. Quick side note, I do enjoy the design themes for Gen 9 starters. I love that all of them are performers, and the themes are represented pretty well in all of the respective mons. Meowscarade with acting, Skeledirge with singing, and Quackuval with dancing. I just can't help but smile. I kind of based this sort of redesign of Skeledirge on a barbershop quartet in Michigan J-Frog, the one who sings and dances this little jig.
Hello, my baby! Hello, my honey! Hello, my ragtime gal!
I love how much of a not-a-bad-guy, bad-guy vibes this piece gives off, the Skeledirge one. Like, he's totally rich AF and is known for doing things like burning down orphanages. But what they don't tell you is the orphanage was not up to code and was insanely dangerous for the orphans. But that's not the full story. He knew it would not be fixed or rebuilt unless an accident happened, so he sponsored a field trip and made sure the building was empty before torching the place. After the thing was burned to the ground, he paid for a proper building, all out of pocket, and made sure it was state of the art. But no one focuses on that. They just focus on the burned down the orphanage thing. Sorry, I know that's a bit dramatic, but it makes me smile. Now let's talk about the elephant in the room. Meowscarade. That diggity dang cat stood up. I'm not mad, just disappointed. Okay, but in all honesty, the design isn't bad and the name is also pretty cute. But overall, it's kind of just eh for me. Meowscarade is the starter my girlfriend picked, and she loves it, so I figured why not do a drawing for the weed cat. I'm not as happy with this pick as I am with Mr. Snazzy, but I like the concept. Keeping the base design of the starters, just changing it up some aspects. I tried to make the weed cat look like it was in a big ball gown, but it just doesn't quite feel right. Its semi redesign is based on an opera singer. I think I might revisit this idea later, but not really sure. It doesn't really click the right, you know, serotonin bells.